So we're sitting here with Mr. Nawfal Al-Jourani. He's the Director of Communications with Dubai Maritime City Authority. It's one of the main destinations for ship owners around the world and for shipping companies as well. And they are among those who are trying to lure Greek ship owners from either Greece or even Cyprus, and lately we hear about the UK as well, where a large Greek shipping community is based. So, Mr. Al-Jourani, let me ask you first. Dubai Maritime City Authority has been around for quite some time now. Can you give us some insight on the developments over the last couple of years?
Well, first, thank you very much for having me here today with you. I would like to begin by saying that we in Dubai, within the United Arab Emirates, are striving to develop our product offering in the maritime industry. And we are looking at best practices all over the world, and we are trying to follow a path that is unique to our identity. That is unique to our identity on one end, and also complementing to other maritime clusters all over the world. And what is it that we offer for the Greek ship owners and ship owners at large is a viable and alternative. An alternative in the sense that it makes sense to become part of Dubai and to do business from Dubai. Not only that we have world's best infrastructure, connectivity, business-friendly government, regulations that are smart, forward-thinking, sustainability in our thinking, innovation-driven government and people, we have also zero tax regime systems. In addition to this, we have a group of talented pools of people who are coming and working in Dubai from all over the world. And within the UAE, it has a very stable political system, a political system that ship owners know better than me is very much needed for them to do their business comfortably, successfully, and smoothly. And we pride ourselves in Dubai that we are in the way of doing a lot to achieving this goal. What we are trying to achieve is a sustainable, vibrant maritime environment in the Emirate, and we genuinely believe that attracting ship owners from Greece and from other geographies as well is a key component to the success of that cluster.
Over the past year, during which we have seen a lot of debate heating up regarding taxation in Greece, have you noticed an increased flow of people asking and inquiring you about what you can provide them?
This is absolutely the case. And look, it is not only this time, before or after. This is an ongoing issue. Tax-based systems and tax-free systems and how you manage taxation, it depends on the product offering of every nation. Each nation decides what best work for them. As far as Dubai is concerned, we, as I said, tax-free systems is not the only product offering that we have. It is on top of that that we have availability of talents, availability of multiculturalism that you have in the country and the UAE, a political system that is business-friendly and that is honestly avoiding bureaucracy as and when we go. In Dubai now, we have indexes not only for satisfaction, but for happiness. We want to make sure that everything we do at the end of the day comes in the form of businesses doing their business successfully and easily.
Have you seen companies from Greece actually relocating to Dubai?
Well, I don't have the numbers with me on now, but I can tell you from my own personal meetings with a lot of ship owners that I've seen in Dubai and I have seen in Athens here from my previous visits, we have a great interest, and it is natural because look, Greek ship owners particularly lead the way now when it comes to the European fleet ownership. And not only with this ownership, their leadership is also in best practice. And for them to sustain that success along the long period of time, it doesn't come as a chance or a coincidence, because they look at what is best for them, what is the value generating solution for them. And that's why there is interest from their side with what is the message that we are sending them now in Dubai. I met with them in various occasions individually and through the context of platform of events such as this, and our message is having the ears of the Greek ship owners.
you were talking about also the danger from Brexit regarding a potential exit of the UK from the European Union and what this could mean for additional interest created from the maritime community, which is based in London this time. Have you seen already demand coming from there as they grow wary of a possible EU exit?
Well, this adds to the earlier point. Greek ship owners and generally ship owners all over the world, what they look at is best practice, and they look at strategies that guarantee for them proper finances, proper management of their people, and making sure that their tonnage is operational and running. Now, with what's happening there, that's an issue relevant to the UAE, to the UK people. But as far as leaving or staying in the European Union, this proves my point earlier, that certain nations, when they handle their gross domestic product when it comes to taxes and what have you, Dubai really shines as a great example and a great opportunity for them to look and seriously consider. Because when you relocate, it's not only about the business. You relocate into a life system. You are not buying into a maritime authority product only. You are buying into the whole culture of a country you are going to relocate to. The reason why London and other examples of clusters that have grown naturally along the years are successful, because they grew naturally. There was no intervention from government to make sure the success of that cluster. Otherwise, I'll give you the opposite example, like Singapore and in Dubai, for example, that we are doing aggressively, is that we are trying to make this growth by decision. We decide that we become a global maritime center. And we decide that we will provide the ship owners with custom-made solutions for them.
Well, the main issue, however, both for ship owners, for most ship owners, is that besides them, you need to attract all the maritime service companies as well.
This is a brilliant...
Ship brokers, companies...
Thank you.
Lawyers...
Yes.
People who ship owners deal with every day.
Exactly. This is a brilliant question. Because if you look at our maritime sector strategy, it is not only the ship owners that are in this strategy, that are the main focus of the strategy, but also the ancillary businesses that they're supporting that. In Dubai, we take pride in being one of the world's top five ports operators and owners. We have also one of the world's best known yards and shipbuilding and services. In Dubai, we have more than 3,000 different companies in the maritime business in chartering, in class, in financing, and in law and in training. Talking about maritime law, we have just recently launched the Middle East first maritime arbitration center under the name EMAC, Emirates Maritime Arbitration Center, which will provide the ship owners again the comfort and relief that there is a big system around them that can address their needs, hardware-wise and software-wise, if you may. Global infrastructure, 4 hours to be here from Dubai to Athens, and 4 hours from Dubai to Singapore and Hong Kong and Shanghai. This makes the geographical location a great added value, but coupled with it, you have infrastructure, air connectivity, land connectivity, and above all, a world-class lifestyle in when you live in the city. I do invite them to come and have a visit, and they will see themselves that I'm not exaggerating. And especially when it comes to the tax regimes, bureaucracy, red tape, you have none of that. In Dubai, you have the world's most advanced smart government. And we gauge ourselves not only with the satisfaction of our customers, but with their happiness.
Which are your plans for the immediate future in terms of announcements? Do you have anything in store?
We have many announcements coming in the future, obviously. But the most recent one that we have launched is the Dubai Maritime Sector Strategy that outlines exactly our roadmap. You know, one of the journalists told me a question that I think was a good question. He said, are you competing with the other clusters? Are you competing with Singapore? Are you competing with London? My answer then and now, simply no. We are complementing. All of these maritime clusters, all of the well-known, most attractive business clusters in the maritime world know that in the Middle East region you do need a thriving, active maritime cluster, because this will reflect positively on their business. You don't want to send your ships to a wasteland. You need to send them to a place where you do your business and get on your way very quickly, successfully, and most importantly, financially viable way.
Thank you very much. I wish you all the best.
Thank you.